Hey guys, this is Typhorus Reacts, and I'm back to react to Naruto, episode 200, The Powerful Helper. And, wow, 200 episodes in, yay! Okay, I'm just gonna start the video, and I'll, okay, so what happened last time, they kept, searching for whatever trap the Trapper Ninja set, and, okay, so first they discovered, like, all the blueprints that fell from the sky, and then it was really just to distract everyone. So they pretty much pinpoint the academy, the Ninja Academy, as the primary location, where, since it was the map that was stolen, in the beginning, at least. So they kept searching and searching, not really finding anything until they suspected this, like, little target post that was in a building that looked relatively new. So they got Neji and Hinata to, you know, scan the thing. Turns out that, like, if you hit the target, like, right on point, it's attached to a wire that would not only blow the academy sky high because there's a paper bomb attached to it, it also blows up pretty much every building in the Leaf Village because, you know, there's just a really long wire attached to that little trap, and it just spread throughout pretty much every building in the village. And just paper bombs everywhere. So now they're gonna have to figure out, okay, how do we get this solved without mass panic? So, okay. Yeah, this is the guy he consistently ate ramen with for a while. I can't tell if that's a joke or it might be important. Okay. Nice. He's a good boy. And Shino's got like millions of Akamarus, pretty much. Miniature, but still. Good thing Tenten's got a large repertoire of, you know, weapons and knowledge of weaponry. Nice. Someone had the foresight to put Naruto and Hinata as a pair. Hey, there we go. Perfect excuse. Oh, yeah, those two. They actually brought these two into this filler arc. Oh boy. Good work, guy. Yeah, he's got a. There's like multiple people involved in this. At least one other guy. Oh no, he's gonna accidentally hit it, isn't he? Oh. Neat. Oh.
me. Putting all the facts together. Antique paper balls, their location, and the fact that they were all hidden without us being aware. It can only mean this trap was set 30 years ago.
Oh. This is a thing 30 years in the making. Oh. The plot keeps getting thicker. Nata, are you okay?
What's wrong?
Oh, okay. Oh, no. Adorable.
He's right on this very spot. The old man was standing when I first met him. And I thought he was just some nice old guy who liked bombing as much as I did. I wonder, is he looking up there for a reason?
Oh boy.
Specifically, Heat Devil Village in the Land of Mountains.
The village disappeared and its name is not found.
Well, let me guess, they completely wiped out the village.
It was at that point that the warlord of Heat Devil Village died in a tragic hunting accident. The man who took his place was one of those who preferred peace, and he accepted the terms of the armistice.
Right about then, Ganon stopped coming to work. I wonder why.
He had finished setting the bombs and disappeared.
So, I prepared to return to my village. I thought the armistice would only be temporary, that I'd soon be sent back to fulfill my mission. I suspect that there would be no more missions for me or anyone from the Heat Devil Village.
2 weeks after the armistice, the village hidden in the Vale attacked, and the Heat Devil Village was destroyed.
Oh. Okay. Oh.
For me to pass in the darkness without anyone ever knowing about what I've done.
Oh.
Why waste them? Why not use them before I die?
Oh. All of a sudden, this guy became one of my favorite villains.
I thought before you died you were gonna. You have a one-track mind, my boy. I said
Wait. Okay. Huh. So yeah, I'll save my discussion on this guy until the episode's over, which is only in like a minute or so. Okay. Well, what is that then? Okay, so it's clearly his motivations aren't quite what he's after hasn't really been revealed yet. But let me discuss this, Genno. Something tells me he doesn't truly care all that much for whatever he's doing this all for, because the true reason he's doing everything isn't to destroy the Leaf Village out of, like, vengeance or anything, as far as I can tell. It's because he wants to. He just feels like he can, because it's just glory. He could die knowing that he was the one who destroyed the Leaf Village pretty much single-handedly. Sure, he had his orders, but he could have just ignored them. After that, he basically said, "No, nobody told me to do this. I just wanted to." And I'm just like, oh. Like, it's not like an Aizen-level betrayal, but... jeez, oh man. I love this arc now. This is probably the best one. I hesitate, we still got one more episode to go. I'll leave my verdict on that until then. But still, oh boy. Yikes, okay. Alright, yeah, I'm just gonna end the video here. I got nothing else to say. It's just great. So yeah, till next time, guys. See ya.